Critical reasoning, the ability to argue answers, creativity are human faculties that need a cognitive approach. Can we find these abilities in artificial intelligence? Currently not, but thanks to technologies, software, and algorithms, we can enhance our skills and reduce our daily workload. Keep watching the video to find out which are the abilities of artificial intelligence. And if you enjoy the topic, feel free to put a like. Can artificial intelligence listen and respond using our language? Yes. Thanks to software that can understand natural language and produce speech synthesis. However, this doesn't mean that it will be able to provide us with answers other than those built into the software's programming. Here is an example. Alexa, Amazon's virtual voice assistant, contains AI-powered software that can provide present answer, do online searches, and read the text in a chosen language. If the user asks similar questions, Alexa will be able to give a number of different but still limited answers because they will depend on the variables chosen during the programming phase. Furthermore, can artificial intelligence see? It depends. The ability to record images and turn a physical space into a digital one is the closest virtual aspect to human sight. These abilities fall under computer vision and are applied through technologies such as video surveillance. In fact, if we want to be alerted in case of a suspicious intrusion, simple recording is not enough. Well, not even an alarm that triggers every movement can help us as it generates false alarms. With AI, however, neural networks detect movements in the surrounding environment and create patterns which identify danger. These, used as filters, allow distinguishing human movements from other irrelevant movements. The same technology, installed in the woods and forests, saves flora and fauna with cameras that detect smoke and set off alarms. We'll now dive into other abilities of AI, but before we go, I would like to know if you are enjoying the video. And should it be so, just comment below with the hashtag artificial intelligence. How does artificial intelligence emulate human thinking? Through neural networks and the use of algorithms typical of deep learning. However, we are still far from obtaining a result as complex as that resulting from human reasoning. Critical thinking is one of the most complex human faculties because it implies the awareness of oneself and the surrounding world. Reasoning, in fact, is a process that goes beyond sense perception and space-time limits. Translating this into data is not easy. Here's an example related to a concrete activity. Let's imagine that the executives want to monitor the workday of a member of their team to understand how to improve business performance. To do this, they will use timesheet software that leverages artificial intelligence. And at the same time, they will ask the employee to take personal notes of activities and times. At the end of the day, they will summon the employee and ask for an oral report. At that time, the executives will have two outputs, the software report and the employee's report. Comparing these two versions will reveal differences. Why? Simple. Because the data collected only describes actions and timing and doesn't contain the added value of interpretation and cognitive analysis. In contrast, the employee's annotated account is constructive because it expresses a point of view based on experience, assumptions, and therefore critical reasoning. In other words, artificial intelligence simulated reasoning works like deductive thinking introduced by Aristotle. All men are mortal. Socrates is a man, therefore Socrates is a mortal. In this sentence, you will start from true premises and true rules and get the correct result. In the case of AI, if you enter verified data and train the software correctly, you will get the exact results. AI is based on a probabilistic system and a computational model. The probability of correct answers increases as more data is entered and as the training path improves. You can then use AI to simulate the following cognitive activities: schedule or plan actions such as those of operating and maintaining machinery, graphically represent data resulting from simple reasoning, the data analysis implemented by the marketing department with specific software is a perfect example of how time and resources are optimized with AI. Finally, what does artificial intelligence actually do? In companies, the combination of artificial intelligence and robotic process automation, better known as RPA, generates a radical change. It improves process efficiency, optimizes time and resources, and reduces the risk of human error. The result of the actions required of a software equipped with artificial intelligence can be of the following type. Number one, descriptive. It scans and lists a series of actions, documents, and or data in general. Number two, predictive. It predicts what might happen in a medium to long time based on the data it analyzes. Number three, prescriptive. Starting from standard models related to the activity you want to analyze, the software can tell you what could still be done to improve performance. Digitizing the entire business system with the use of programs that leverage automation and AI allows, for example, to achieve constant interaction between departments working on the same process, but at different stages. Again, automate activities that require dedicated resources and high time scales, as well as the risk of making mistakes in repetition, and get answers from processing huge amount of complex data to manage. If you would like to know more about automation, feel free to give a glimpse to the video right here in the corner, which is just focused on that. In the era of digital transformation, it's important to be aware of the potential that AI and automation offer, without confusing them with the power of human abilities to feel, act, and think. The suggestion is to look at digital as an asset of indispensable tools to grow business and further enhance your cognitive capabilities. If you found the video interesting, hurry up and subscribe to my YouTube channel as more content will come shortly. Plus, click on the bell to make sure you receive a direct notification whenever I publish a new video. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Ciao!